Well, hi, I'm Stephen Holt. But you all knew that, didn't you? Because you saw this sign for a wedding most strange. Well, some people would say that's me in television. I mean, I've been on it for 23 years. Can you believe it? Yeah, that's how old you are, too, because you've been watching all this time. And we're here still at the Montreal Film Festival, where everything's just a little pink, you know, La Vie en Rose. Well, anyway, this morning I have, and you're watching it at midnight on Channel 56 on Time Warner, or Channel 83 on RCN, or Channel 34 on Fios. I can barely remember. I'm all over the place. What can I say? And so is this conversation. But we're going to introduce you now to a brand new director who's making his debut with his film, A Wedding Most Strange, here at the Montreal World Film Festival. It's Trevor Garlick. Hey, Trevor.
Hello, how are you?
Yes, you can't kidnap me at breakfast this morning. It was delightful.
I did. I saw you sitting there, and I couldn't resist.
I get that a lot. Anyway, Trevor, you're from England. You're British, but right. You're
living in France. Yeah.
C'est très intéressant,
oui. It's good. France is a very creative place. I live in the mountains with all
mountains.
With all the goats and the goat herders, and it's great, you know.
What mountains? The Alps?
French Alps. It's good.
Oh, so then you're Swiss.
You're kind of.
A Swiss Miss. We're about to talk to Francine Boucher, you know, from Swiss Films. The Swiss Miss of Swiss Films is coming up right after you. But anyway, so tell us about your life as a filmmaker and your coming here and your very interesting new movie.
Sure. So we're here with A Wedding Most Strange. I've been movie making now for 3 years. I've been writing scripts for the last 8 years and decided that the only opportunity I was going to get into the business was to get into the business. So we're very much at the independent end. And this is my first feature movie.
We are too, by the way.
So wrote the first movie, started pre-production beginning of September last year, made the movie over a 3-week period in February of 2011, came through post-production, and this is our first festival here in Montreal. So it's our world premiere.
In North America, wow. And judging by this intriguing picture, it looks like it's a gay wedding, but it's a multiracial gay wedding. It looks like it's an Indian bride and a British groom, or a British groom and an Indian groom, or what's going on here?
It is. It's very much an East meets West wedding movie. The lead protagonist, a guy called Danny, has got 2 weeks to effectively find himself a husband and get married to reclaim his heritage as per his father's will.
Is the Indian guy?
No, this is he's a British guy. So he goes searching on the internet. He's got to find his love. He has 2 weeks to do it. And he kind of gets surprised at the amount of people that actually see him as a regular guy that they could spend the rest of their life with. And his friends join in when they realize what he's doing, because he doesn't come out with it straight away. And I think when his friends turn up to the wedding venue, just as much as I kind of do, I look at the people who are going to get married and I say, would I marry one of these people? And that can progress into, I would want to marry you, and therefore maybe you make a play for that person. So this is what this movie is about. This guy actually ends up with many more choices than he believed he would ever have.
Yes, that's what happens when every time I put an ad on Mandy.com for a camera person. Oh my God, the response, yeah.
This is the film version of that, absolutely.
Oh, it's the film version of the Stephen Holt Show, okay. I like that. Okay. So you're up in the Alps. I mean, this French Swiss Alps can compute to a film career? I don't.
Well, actually,
the goats and sheep help you.
It's great for writing.
Nothing else to do except stare at the mountains.
Right. And watch all the cyclists and the Lycra and all that. I mean, there's loads to do in the Alps. So, writing is good. It's very well connected. I'm 60 miles from Geneva. It's just a flight. It's just a train. And you're really well connected. So you're in the middle of nowhere, close to everything.
Oh, okay. And you chose to leave London because you were just sick of it?
I was stressed with it, for sure. I've been there for 12 years. I had a
Where
very...
London, where are you living?
Central London, just southeast London, just near Tower Bridge.
I used to live. Oops. Andrew Logan and Butler's Wharf. It got burnt down and is now, that's where you live.
Yeah, I lived 2 minutes' walk from Butler's Wharf.
Oh, mon Dieu.
Mon Dieu, there you go. We could have met each other in a previous history.
Well, what happened was that it all got burnt down by the landlord slash arsonists, and before it was redeveloped on the other side, it's now very pricey, but in those days, they had the streets back there where they film all the, you know, Charles Dickens.
Right. Absolutely.
Are those streets still
intact?
Yeah,
yeah, you know? Absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah, they're all
and you walk across back and forth on Tower Bridge at night and smell malt.
Right.
Exactly. Is that still there? The Watney's factor? Yeah. Oh, that's great. There was this smell of malt. You can't describe that.
Yeah.
The smell of malt on Tower Bridge now, at midnight.
Oh, right. Yeah. It has shifted now because of the price of property, but yeah. When I first got there, it was there.
Oh, it's shifted now. Yeah, oh, it's gone. Yeah, so the malt is gone. You can't go there, ladies and gentlemen.
No. You have to sniff out something else.
Yes. The ghost of Anne Boleyn still walking. Do they still have the Tower of London there?
They do, yeah.
Yeah, I would often, you know, the first time I was taken to Windsor Castle, I was told, oh, this is the hall where one of the queens that Henry VIII beheaded ran screaming through the halls the night
just before she lost it. Yeah.
Which one was that, Anne?
You're putting me on the spot. No, it was the one just before, wasn't it? It was one after. Oh, brilliant.
Catherine.
No, she did. No, she did, but there was two before that was the original one.
Okay. You got me right on the spot. Divorced, beheaded, died. Divorced, beheaded. Since we're talking about marriage in England today, look at what the heterosexuals do with it. And then they founded a church. How can anyone take the Church of England seriously with this?
Right.
God. Okay, divorced, beheaded, which was Anne Boleyn. Catherine of Aragon was divorced. Beheaded was Anne Boleyn. Died, which was the one who died in childbirth.
Yeah.
And then divorced was Anne of Cleves, beheaded. It's that other, the second beheading.
Exactly.
That has nothing to do with your movie, but this is what happens to heterosexuals in England. If you go there, you've got to marry a gay man or you're going to get your head cut off.
Exactly.
Or look what happened to Princess Di. Do we dare? I mean, the name. We watched that on television.
Right.
Was that all what was really happening? All those flowers, all the outpouring?
Yeah, absolutely. From that...
That's all true. I thought it was some kind of...
I think...
Optical illusion.
It was an eye-opener for the royal family. It was a big moment. I think certainly the country, but a lot of the world, truly loved that lady. She was very special. She was very different. And she did her own thing. You know, she was the one breaking the eggshells the whole time because she was going to live her life in the way that she saw fit. And I think that is what people miss the most.
Well, when I was a char in London with being gay sweatshop, walking down memory lane here, Charles was single at the time. Mm-hmm. It was way before he even met Diana, and he was beloved.
Right.
He was beloved by everybody, and then that changed.
Yeah. Yeah, that's because
analyzing the royal family. What are we doing? Well,
it's not
about
quite
a wedding. A wedding most strange. Certainly Charles and Diana.
Exactly. I mean, he was already having an affair with Camilla by then. So, and when the country found that out, I think that was the turning point. Once they had realised, he admitted on TV, they both did interviews. Actually, it was about a year before Diana passed away, where they did interviews and came clean with what it was they were getting up to. And he admitted to adultery with Camilla, who obviously he's now married to. So,
and now back to your movie.
Right, well, there was two weddings. He got the right answer on his second wedding. And not to give everything away, but there is a similar theme that runs through this story. We don't always make the choices right first time. If you follow your heart, you see what
especially
it is you want.
Especially in gay life.
Absolutely.
I wonder how gay life has changed since I was there. Well, I was there pre-AIDS, so I'm sure it's really different now. And everybody I knew is probably almost all gone.
Right. It's kind of a wild city from the gay scene perspective.
But Andrew Logan is still there. Hello, Andrew. Yes.
No, it's good. It's a vibrant city. It's a good city. The gay village is enormous. Yeah, there's a lot going on.
Where is the gay village in London?
Well, it was Soho. It's now kind of shifted to Vauxhall, so it's now gone south of the river.
Oh.
Albeit southwest. So it's now...
Which is where Andrew lives now, come to think of it.
Right. It's big. The Vauxhall area under the bridges, you know, the little dark tunnels and all that kind of stuff.
Yes, I remember vividly. It was wonderful.
The only thing we miss now is the mist. Yeah, there's no mist and smog. You know, it's kind of clean.
I first went to England, there was no fog. As they have was historically, but they cleaned it up.
Yeah, they did. You're not allowed to have fires.
And now you have this big Ferris wheel.
Right.
And a building that looks like a pickle.
Yeah, exactly. The gherkin.
The
exactly,
gherkin.
Yeah.
I didn't want to say gherkin, but for fear of mispronouncing it, it's not a bad word. It means
cigar.
A pickle.
Cigar, maybe. It's called the cigar as well. There's a new one. There's a new one on the south of the river. Once again, called the Shard. That'll be ready in about 2 years' time. Complete glass, much bigger, much different. Yeah, it's the
well,
land.
Anyway, we're having a gay old time with a wedding most strange at a festival most wonderful, the Montreal World Film Festival. Thank you so much,
thank
Trevor,
you. Thank you.
For
wonderful
being
to
here
meet
today.
You. Thank you.
I'm very personable and personal purple sofa, chairs, whatever, at the Montreal World Film Festival. Merci beaucoup. Merci beaucoup.
Merci.